نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ولا مثيل له ولا شبيه له ولا ند له ولا ضد له ولا مماثل له وأشهد أن سيدنا وسندنا هادينا ومرشدنا أفضلنا وأكرمنا وأعلانا إمامنا وقدوتنا سيدنا محمدا عبده ورسوله صلوات الله وسلامه عليه أرسله بالحق بين يدي الساعة بشيرا ونذيرا وداعيا إلى الله بإذنه وسراجا منيرا فمن يطع الله ورسوله فقد رشد واهتدى ومن يعص الله ورسوله فقد ضل وغوى ولا يضر إلا نفسه ولن يضر الله شيئا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أحسن الكلام كلام الله وأحسن الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم من همزه ونفخه ونفثه يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون My dear brothers and my dear sisters, living as a Muslim, as somebody who professes Iman, faith and belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, belief in His Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, belief in the hereafter, then as a Muslim we do not live in this dunya, we do not live in this world as if we are in a bubble, as if we are in a vacuum. Rather, a Muslim knows where they are in their life, knows where they are in the society, knows where they are in the year. But nowadays, if you were to stop somebody, for an example, if you were to stop somebody and ask them, what day is it? Then they'll perhaps reply to you, it's the 6th of August. If you say, no, I meant what day is it in the Hijri calendar, little among us would be able to answer you. Little among us would know the date today in the Hijri calendar, being the 27th of Dhul Hijjah in this year 1442 Hijri. Perhaps many of us, we may be only aware of when Ramadan comes in, when Eid al-Fitr is about to come upon us, and when Eid al-Adha. That's the only dates we know in the Islamic calendar. Perhaps some among us may be aware of when, for example, Rabi'ul Awwal will start, or when it is Laylatul Nisfi min Sha'ban. But little among us are aware as to where we are standing in the Islamic calendar. Few among us are aware of this reality. And subhanAllah, this is the extent of our knowledge. But time has been placed there by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for a purpose, for us to take heed of, for us to take advantage of, and for us to benefit from the passage of time. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, the ayah I begun my khutbah with, O you who believe, have fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, have taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَلْتَنْظُرْ نَفْسٌ مَا قَدَّمَتْ لِغَدْ And let each person look, let each person consider as to what they have put forth from their deeds for tomorrow. What have they done on that particular day? What have they done with the time that passes them by in order to put forward for what is to come tomorrow, the hereafter, Yawmul Akhir. وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ. So then again, have taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for certainly Allah dhul jalal, Allah rabbul ardi was sama, He is completely aware of what it is that you perform. And as we are coming now toward the end of this Hijri year, toward the end of this calendar year, the end of this month of Dhul Hijjah, then it is upon us now to pause and to reflect and to ponder as to how have we spent the year that has gone before us. What have we put forth in our deeds for tomorrow? What have we done to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And what is there for us to seek tawbah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to seek forgiveness of the sins we have put forth for tomorrow? What is it that we have done? Let us now reconsider and let us now ponder over the time that has passed before us. And many of us, we may have not even realized that the quick reality that time has passed us by. How quickly the days and nights have passed us by in this past year and the years gone by. How quickly time is passing by. And that is actually, as we have discussed, is from Ashratu Sa'ah. It is from the signs of Yawm Al-Qiyamah that time will run by extremely quickly, as in Sahih Bukhari and Sahih Muslim. Sayyidina Abu Hurairah radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he says that our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam said that la taqumu sa'a, the hour will not be established, the day of resurrection will not come upon mankind up until يقبض العلم, up until knowledge is lifted, knowledge is taken away from the people. وَتَكْثُرَ الزَّلَازِلِ, and earthquakes become more and more common among mankind. وَيَتَقَارَبَ الزَّمَانِ, and the time will be brought near. يَتَقَارَبَ الزَّمَانِ, the time will be brought near in proximity, close in nearness to the people. And the ulama, the muhaddithun alayhim ar-ridwan, they have written that what this means, يَتَقَارَبَ الزَّمَانِ, that the time will be brought close in proximity, it means that the barakah will be removed from time. Because the sun and the moon are the same sun and moon that the previous generations they had and that measured the time for them. It is the same constellations that we have. It is the same heavenly planets that we see. It is the same sun and the same moon that we have to measure our time by. The nights and the days are the same. The alternation of day and night is the same. But what has been removed, what has changed, it is the removal of barakah, the removal of blessings from our time. And when we ponder on the time we have, the barakah we have in our time, and the barakah that the a'imma of the past had in their time, we see what a great colossal difference there is. For example, if we take Shaykh al-Islam, Imam Ibn Taymiyyah rahmahullah ta'ala, his students write that he authored his monumental work Al-Hamawiyyah, Ar-Risalatul Hamawiyyah. He authored that work between the time of Dhuhr and Asr. He authored that work. Similarly, his book Al-Tadmuriyyah or Al-Wasitiyyah, Afwan, his Aqidatul Wasitiyyah, then he authored that book Fi Laylatin Wahida. In one night he compiled that book. Imam Abu Zakariya al-Nawawi rahimahullah ta'ala, a scholar, an alim of the past, who every single Muslim household has his books, Riyadu Salihin, his Sharh of Sahih Muslim, his Arba'un, the books of the Muslim, the libraries of the Muslims are filled with the books of Imam al-Nawawi rahmahullah ta'ala. He lived for how many years? 45 years he lived on this dunya. But the amount of works that he produced, the plethora of authorships he produced, the scholars, they write that if we were to calculate how many pages he wrote, then in one day he accomplished what other scholars accomplished before him in 2 years. How much barakah he had in his time. And we compare that time with our time and how we are fuqdanul barakah, hirmanul barakah. We are deprived of barakah in our times. And that is from Ashratu Sa'ah. That is from the signposts of Yawm Al-Qiyamah. So what is meant, what is wanted from us, what is matlub and murad from us, what is wanted from us is to use our time. As we are coming out toward the end of the year, we should use our time. This should be a reminder for us, as that the year is coming to an end, then one day our lives will also come to an end. Our lifespans will also one day come to an end. So what is wanted from us is to use our time in that which pleases Allahu Rabbul Izzati wal Jalal, is to use that time to bring us nearer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this time we are in, we are about to embark onto the next Hijri year, the year 1443 Hijri. And that month, we are about to embark in that month, which is likewise among Ashhurul Hurum, among the sanctified sacred months of the year, that month of Al-Muharram, of Muharram, that month which Sayyidina Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu narrates in Sahih Muslim, that our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam said that أَفْضَلُ الصِّيَامِ بَعْدَ رَمَضَانِ شَهْرُ اللَّهِ الْمُحَرَّمِ, that the most virtuous of fasting after the month of Ramadan, after that fasting which is imposed upon you, which is obligated upon you, which is mandatory upon you, is the fasting done in the month of Muharram. وَأَفْضَلُ الصَّلَاةِ بَعْدَ الْفَرِيضَةِ صَلَاةُ اللَّيْلِ, and the most virtuous of standing after the obligatory prayers is the standing in the night time. So meaning we should use our time to seek the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Use the time we are about to embark on to engage in those ibadat which are most beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. عَلَيْكَ بِالصَّوْمِ فَإِنَّهُ لَا عِدْلَ لَهُ, upon you is to fast, to engage in fasting, for there is nothing at all similar to that ibadah. There's nothing to equate to fasting for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So time, and taking note of time, is something extremely important and wanted by a Muslim, to such an extent that Allah Rabbul Izzati wal Jalal, whenever he takes an oath in his book subhanahu wa ta'ala, whenever he takes a qasam, then he takes a qasam, he takes an oath by something of great importance, something we should take and we should ponder upon. And many times in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes his oaths by various aspects of time. And one of the most ironic places Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes an oath in is in Surah Al-Asr. That surah which is 3 ayahs long. A surah many of us we read when we are in what condition? When we are in a hurry, when we are in a rush, we should quickly pray and get over it and get on with whatever it is that we need to do. How ironic that is, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in that surah, what does he say? He swears subhanahu wa ta'ala, he takes a qasam jalla wa ala by time. Wal asr, I take an oath by time, by asr ay ad-dahr, by the passage of time. Why? إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَفِي خُسْرٍ, because of the neglection of time, because of the overlooking of time, mankind is in loss. And we overlook and we use this surah when we are in a rush, when where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reprimanding us for that very thing, that we overlook and we neglect our time. إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَفِي خُسْرٍ, certainly mankind is in a condition of loss and perpetual loss because of their neglection of using time to seek the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the passage of time, by the passage of time we are in loss, until a time will come upon us when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, وَأَنذِرِ النَّاسَ يَوْمَ يَأْتِيهِمُ الْعَذَابِ فَيَقُولُ الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا رَبَّنَا أَخِّرْنَا إِلَىٰ أَجَلٍ قَرِيبٍ نُجِيبَ دَعَوَتَكَ وَنَتَّبِعِ الرُّسُلِ, that warn the people of a day when the punishment will be brought upon them, when Qiyamah will be established upon them, when the day of resurrection will dawn upon them. Warn them from that day. وَأَنذِرِ النَّاسَ, warn them away from that day. And on that day, what will the zalimun, the oppressors, those who wronged themselves, those who committed injustice to themselves, what will they say? فَيَقُولُ الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا, they will ask Allah, رَبَّنَا أَخِّرْنَا إِلَىٰ أَجَلٍ قَرِيبٍ, give us a respite for a short amount of time. إِلَىٰ أَجَلٍ قَرِيبٍ, a short amount of time. We want nothing from you, O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, except to give us a short amount of time. That way we may seek your pleasure, we may engage ourselves in those deeds which are beloved to you, O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so that we may not go back, and how we wasted our time, we will not waste it again. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions again, حَتَّى إِذَا جَاءَ أَحَدَهُمُ الْمَوْتِ فَيَقُولُ, up until death comes up until one of them, and he says, رَبِّ ارْجِعُونَ, oh my Lord, send me back. لَعَلِّي أَعْمَلُ صَالِحًا فِي مَا تَرَكْتُ, send me back to this dunya, give me more time. لَعَلِّي أَعْمَلُ صَالِحًا, in order that I may perform good deeds, فِي مَا, in that which I left behind. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, كَلَّا, never. لعلي أعمل صالحا فيما تركت. كلا إنها كلمة هو قائلها ومن ورائهم برزخ إلى يوم يبعثون. Behind them there is a barrier, there is a barzakh. They will never ever be allowed to trespass that barzakh. They will never ever be allowed to come back into this dunya. While we have time, while we have our bodies are still pumping blood, while our hearts are still beating, we should use that time not to disobey Allah Rabbul Izzati wal Jalal, but to seek His pleasure subhanahu wa ta'ala, lest we be among those people who will cry out when death comes to us, wanting more time. Only if, oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, You granted me more time, I could pray 2 rak'ahs, I could give some money in sadaqah, I could help somebody in need, I could fast one day for Your sake, oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Kalla, never. Never will Allah subhanahu allow such a person to come back into this dunya. Whoever it is that الَّذِي خَرَجَ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا, the one who leaves from this life, there is no chance for them to ever come back. So use this time, the time that we have, the time Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has granted to us, has gifted upon us in his pleasure subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hence why Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he used to say, حَاسِبُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ, bring yourselves to account, account yourselves. As now the year is coming to an end, in a couple of days this Hijri year will come to an end. Account yourselves for that year. Ponder and sit and think, what have you achieved in this year? قَبْلَ أَن تُحَاسَبُوا, before you are brought to account by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For when you are brought to account by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَظْلِمُ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّا, then whatever it is that you performed, whatever it is that you did in this dunya, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never commit any iota of injustice to any one of His slaves. Whatever you did in terms of evil, that will be a witness against you, and whatever you did in terms of goodness, then that will be there in your mizan of hasanat. And when we look at our aslaf alayhim ridwan, our predecessors, and how they were with their time, khayru tabi'in, Imam Hassan al-Basri rahmahullahu ta'ala, who he was brought up and he was nurtured in the household of Nubuwa, in the lap of Sayyida Ummul Mu'mineen, Sayyida Salama radiyallahu ta'ala anha, who he said, adraktu qawman, I caught up to a people, I found a nation of people, kanu ala awqatihim, they were over their time, أشد منكم حرصا على دراهمكم ودنانيركم, they were more keen over their time, they were more earnest over their time than you are with your dananir and with your darahim, with your pounds and in your pennies. The same way you are so keen to keep hold of your pounds and your pennies, I found a nation, I found a group of people. Who are they? The Sahabatul Kiram alayhim ridwan. I found the Sahaba, the talamidha of our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the nursery of our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I found them, and they were, in regards to their time, they were the same way, they were more keen and more earnest on keeping hold of and making use of their time. Likewise, Sayyiduna Abdullah ibn Mas'ud al-Hudhali radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he used to say that ma nadimtu ala shay'in, I was never more remorseful and more regretful over anything, kanadami ala yawmin, like my remorse and my regret over a day that passed me by, gharabat shamsu, that the sun of that day is set, the sun of that day is set behind the horizon, wa naqasa fihi min ajali, and my age became less in that day, because as every day passes by, our age passes by, our lifespan passes by with every single day that passes us by, وَلَمْ يَزِدْ فِيهِ عَمَلِي, and my actions were not increased in that day. I never had any more remorse than that, than a day finished, a day concluded, the sun set, and I was unable to increase myself, increase my actions for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولجميع المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء وسيد المرسلين نبينا ورسولنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين ثم أما بعد الله رب العزة والجلال رب الأرض والسماء. He brings our attention to one aspect and he says سبحانه وتعالى ألم ترى. Have you not seen and have you not considered أن الله سخر لكم ما في السماوات وما في الأرض. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He has subjugated for you and He has put to your subservience whatever there is in the heavens and in the earth. وَأَسْبَغَ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعَمَهُ ظَاهِرَةً وَبَاطِنًا. And Allah subhanahu, He has not only given you His blessings, rather He subhanahu wa ta'ala has amply bestowed upon you. وَأَسْبَغَ عَلَيْكُمْ, in a plethora, He has amply bestowed upon you His blessings, those which you are able to see and those which are hidden from your eyes. ظَاهِرَةً وَبَاطِنًا, those which are visible and those which are invisible. And in those ni'am, those blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is the blessing of time, is the blessing of the passage of day and night, the alternation, the khilfa of day and night. That is from the huge blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He has gifted to us. And in regards to the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, likewise in Sahih Bukhari and Sahih Muslim, Sayyidina Abu Huraira radiyallahu ta'ala anhu arda, mahbubul muslimin, mahbubul mustafa, Sayyidina Abdurrahman bin Sakhar radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, unzuru ila man huwa asfala minkum, wa la tanzuru ila man huwa fawqakum, fahuwa ajdaru alla tazdaru ni'matallahi alaykum. Look, when you observe those around you, then look toward those who are lesser than you, and do not look at those who are above you, for that is more deserving. That the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon you are not trivialized, are not taken, and you trivialize them, you belittle the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when we look around at those who have been given blessings by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, perhaps some of us may be elder, and those who are younger among us, they have been given this blessing of time by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We should not look at them. Rather, we should look at those who have passed before us. إِلَى مَنْ هُوَ أَسْفَلَ مِنْكُمْ. In this context of time, of waqt, of zaman, then those who have passed before us. Pass but walk by a graveyard. Walk by the maqabir and see those who are dead and those who are buried. What do you think they wish is? To be sent back into this dunya. That tamanni that they have, that hope and that wishing that they have, you have that blessing which they wish for. So do not trivialize that blessing of time given to you by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For certainly the blessings of Allah subhanahu, you will be questioned. ثُمَّ لَتُسْأَلُنَّ يَوْمَئِذٍ عَنِ النَّعِيمِ. On the day of resurrection, every single blessing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted and bestowed and blessed you with, you will be held accountable by that, by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For that, you will be held accountable, and Allah Dhul Jalali wal Ikram will judge you for that, how it was that you used that ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And from those ni'am, as you mentioned, is the blessing of time. And we'll finish with how people, they squandered this blessing. As Sayyidina Habrul Ummah, Tarjumanul Quran, ابن عم رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم سيدنا عبد الله بن عباس بن عبد المطلب رضي الله تعالى عنهما. He said that Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, نعمتان مغبون فيهما كثير من الناس الصحة والفراغ. That there are two blessings from Allah, two bestowals from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that many people they waste and they squander. الصحة والفراغ, health and free time. Time is one of those timely blessings given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As this Hijri calendar is coming to an end and we go into the next Hijri calendar, let us re-evaluate ourselves. Let us look what we did correct in this year and what we did not achieve in this year. And that which you did not achieve in this year, that which you set out, the goals which you set and you did not achieve, then do not fear and do not grieve. For still we have the blessing of time given to us by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالنِّيَّاتِ. Your deeds will be by their intentions. Set your azima, set your determination that in the coming Hijri calendar, you will fulfill all those goals which you intended to achieve. You will seek to fulfill the rights of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You will intend to seek nearness and at-taqarrub to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa naktafi bihada wa sallu wa sallimu ra'akum Allah ala man umirtum bis salati wa salami alayhi yaqulu tabaraka tasma'u wa jalla thana'u inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala nabi ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima. Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala ali Muhammad kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim innaka hamidun majid. Allahumma barik ala Muhammadin wa ala ali Muhammad كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم وفقنا لما تحب وترضى. اللهم زيننا بزينة الإيمان وجعلنا هداة مهتدين. اللهم حبب إلينا الإيمان وزينه في قلوبنا وكره إلينا الكفر والفسوق والعصيان وجعلنا مع الراشدين. اللهم طهر قلوبنا من النفاق وأعمالنا من الرياء وألسنتنا من الكذب وأعيننا من الخيانة فإنك تعلم خائنة الأعين وما تخفي الصدور. اللهم اغفر لنا ولجميع موتانا وموتى المسلمين واشفنا واشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين. ربنا آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين.